Hey, what's up, everybody? So today I'm going to be showcasing one of the best and probably one of the last versions of the LEGO RC car series that I've been working on. So as you can see here, it doesn't even look like it's made out of Legos, and that's because I've got this low C, like 1/24th scale, this rally car body on it, and I just ordered that off of Amazon. I built the LEGO frame around it, and I strapped my usual electronics on. And then upgraded them later, which I'll talk about in a sec. So first, let's take a look under the hood and see what's going on under this shell that we've got on here. So it just comes off like this. It has these little Lego, like ball-topped connector pieces. You snap it right off, and there we go. There's the interior. Now, I did have to make the body a lot smaller. I started with the micro rally drift car, I think I called it. I started with that body, and that body was a little bit too big to be a 1/24th scale and exactly fit this body. So I had to make it even smaller and condense everything into this tiny little package that you see here. So first of all, I've got the same motor on there. Let's see if you can see it. I think it's like a 1700 kV little Hobby King motor or something like that. It came with some 3D plane that I showcased a while ago, and I didn't use it. And I decided to throw it on this because I didn't really have anything else to put it on. And then have an epoxied and hot glued modified little Lego connector there coming out of the motor and connecting to this shaft, going through this connector piece and hooking up to this. This is actually like a wheel part without the tire on it, and it acts as like a really nice pulley for it. I got down here a larger pulley system, so small to big equals more torque, and that gives it, even with that, it gives it quite the power. It can go up like pretty much anything, and it drives like really nice, as you'll see later. I've also got this little secondary gear. I don't know if you can see it there, the little pulley, and that keeps it so that the rubber band, which is actually a DVD disc drive belt that I started using, so it can stay on a lot better. I also have the double pulleys just in case if it decides to slip anyway, it'll still be able to drive away and I'll be able to recover it and fix it. So over here, I think I've crammed like an 800 milliamp hour battery in there. I upgraded the servo to like a 12 gram Metal Gear digital servo, so I got all of the upgrades. Hopefully that won't blow out because I've blown out at least three servos. I've stripped the gears or like killed their little boards inside by driving it like this, but hopefully that'll fix it. Then I put a Traxxas receiver right there so I can connect it to my TQ that I use for my Rustler. And then this is the most important part, which is this little cheap 18 amp RC car ESC, and that is so key in making this actually drive like an RC car, because not only does it make the pickup so that it's not more oriented towards constant RPM like the regular aircraft ESCs, but it can also reverse, which is super super nice. And it also has this on-off switch, so that's pretty cool. I still have the same steering mechanism as I had on my old car. Just works sort of like that. I'm not really gonna explain it right now just because I've already explained it in my drift car video, but you sort of get what's going on there. It has like the static rear piece, and then the front piece moves back and forth with the servo arm. Fortunately, this thing still retains its speed like it had in the drift car video, and it goes, I don't even know how fast, it goes like at least 20, maybe a little bit more than that. It doesn't really like going any faster than that just because it's so small, and if you turn too sharp and it doesn't understeer, it'll just flip and roll, as you can see with these like scratches I have here. But other than that, it's crazy fast. It's like better than the car that was actually designed for this body, which is insane. The one thing I wish I could add were a suspension system and shocks, because that would really, really help with bumps and stuff like that. Hopefully I'm going to be getting the wheels that were actually for this car body, and hopefully those will not only add some more grip, but also make it so that the ride's a little bit more cushiony. So enough talking, let's go see how it drives.